know, this year's been a pretty interesting one for us already. We had quite a strong start to the year, I'd say. Maybe started a little bit at the end of December when we announced that we were shutting down our Flow network and selling the spectrum to AT&T for over $1.9 billion. And the interesting part about that is that they're going to use the spectrum for a technology called supplemental downlink. And if you go to our booth, you can see how supplemental downlink works. It's essentially the idea that you would pair the uplink in the with more than one downlink technology. So that's going to provide additional capacity because, as you know, traffic is very asymmetric and there's more data that goes down to the device than comes up. So exciting news there. Obviously, we have the launch of LTE at Verizon, very strong launch, announcements of the LTE smartphone. In addition to USB dongles, launch at Docomo as well. So that's also great to see. And then kind of a follow on to that, we bought spectrum in India, and really the idea there was to drive TD-LTE as a technology in India. That appears to have worked. It was a good announcement yesterday by three operators, including Bharti Airtel, talking about their commitment to TD-LTE. The other two operators were China Mobile and SoftBank. So a really good momentum around that technology, and I think, you know, it's a sign that WiMAX is going to get any traction in India, and I think probably story about how it's going to progress globally is something similar to that. So we're happy to see TD-LTE get the traction there. Another announcement we made this year was the acquisition of Atheros, and a lot of people think that we bought Atheros because we have some gap in our chipset roadmap on Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, but in fact, we've already made the announcements of Snapdragon coming up with integrated Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, and what the acquisition of Atheros was about is our belief that as we've integrated more and more consumer electronics and computing functionality into the phone, and reduce the cost and the size of the power, now we're going to see those chips proliferate into devices outside of the phone, into displays and speakers and lights and various content sources and all sorts of things, printers, access points. And Atheros has the products and sales channels for those markets. And so we see a great opportunity to add our technology to theirs, our products to theirs, to cross-pollinate between the two, but also to add those sales channels to the sales channels that we have already. We also announced at our earnings call we had a licensing dispute. One of two that we had been talking about was resolved. One of the two, we significantly raised our financial guidance because of that. And we also announced on the Mirasol, we've been working on this display technology, so it was an announcement of nearly $1 billion investment in a new fab in Taiwan to build those displays, targeted for sometime next year to see products rolling out of that factory. On the operating system side, we saw a lot of activity already this year. So obviously the iPhone launched at Verizon. We launched in conjunction with HP last week. We launched the WebOS, and their tablet, the touchpad, uses our 8660 dual-core Snapdragon processor. Obviously, you know, big news at the conference is Windows Phone 7 and the Nokia deal with Microsoft. Snapdragon powers all the Windows Phone 7 devices as well. And CES this year, Microsoft also announced that they're porting big Windows onto the ARM platform, did demonstrations of big Windows running on top of Snapdragon as well. And finally, I just came from the HTC press conference right before this, and they showed off their new tablet design based off of our 8X55 chipset. They showed six devices, all of which were powered by Qualcomm Snapdragons, but the Flyer tablet that they showed off was running at 1.5 gigahertz. So very exciting stuff going on that side as well. Those were Android data. So across the board, across across all the different operating systems. A lot of excitement. Obviously, Steve's going to get into much more detail about what's going on the chipset side, because we've been making very, very significant investments on the chipset side. We've been talking a lot about growth drivers for Qualcomm's business, and there's really five key growth drivers that we see going forward, at least in the near term. And obviously, we've been really beneficiaries and drivers of the transition from 2G to 3G. We see roughly 1.2 billion subscribers using 3G right now. We look at that number probably doubling. Those are the estimates that are out there, roughly doubling over the next few years. We got about 85% of the world's networks that now support 3G. And the other interesting thing, from the handset shipment standpoint, we recently updated our guidance on that and said at the midpoint, we thought in the calendar 2010, about 650 million 3G devices were sold out, with roughly 1.4 billion total devices. For calendar 2011, we're projecting 775 billion devices at the midpoint. And I think the projections, these are all analyst projections, almost 1.5 billion devices. So we're gaining share in terms of 3G shipments in terms of handsets. So that continues to be a great story for us. But a huge amount of growth, because we're at 1.2 billion subscribers out of roughly 5 billion subscribers. And so a tremendous growth opportunity ahead of us still on 2G to 3G, and now we're starting to see the beginnings of a 4G rollout as well. Emerging markets is another significant growth driver for Qualcomm. We've seen the rollouts now of 3G in almost all regions. We're very excited by what's happening in China. Very significant growth in China. Only about 15% of the 842 million subscribers in China use 3G today. But if you look at the aggressiveness of the operators there driving 3G, that's very exciting. And India, another market where we see a lot of opportunity. We now see the operators rolling out the 3G networks there, and we also expect to see 4G networks roll out relatively soon in India as well. You heard Enrico talk about smartphones. We expect, based on the analysts that reported, we expect in 2011 440 million smartphones to be sold. And that's just a pretty significant number when you think that the overall number of shipments of devices is about 1.5 billion. So a very large fraction of the devices that are going to be shipped are going to be smartphones. If you tie the smartphone market and the emerging market trends together, you see why we're pressing hard to drive the cost point of smartphones down significantly. We see tremendous growth opportunities in the smartphone tiers below about $250. The other thing is we see smartphones obviously becoming the computing device for many people. I don't know how many of you do what I do, but I sit at my desk sometimes in front of my PC and I still read my email on my smartphone because it's just faster and easier. It's already synchronized. I don't have to wait. And if you look in the fourth quarter of 2010, smartphone shipments outstripped the PC shipments. So we're already ahead of PC shipments. I think that's a trend that's going to continue. And I think based off of that, what Microsoft announced, I think PCs have become more towards the smartphone space, more towards the type of devices that Steve's team has been building and bringing to market. So excitement in that opportunity as well. And the operators are very happy with the smartphone trend as well, because they're seeing their data revenues grow pretty dramatically. If you look across a number of the large operators, 25, 26, 27% growth year over year in terms of revenues driven by data. Another area that's a key growth driver for us is all the new types of devices. So clearly this year is a year where everybody's talking about tablets. Steve will talk to you a lot about our Snapdragon tablets. market, and I think you'll see some really exciting stuff coming out in terms of tablets. But it's more than just tablets, it's e-readers and gaming devices and all sorts of, you know, things, consumer electronics, nav systems, and photo frames. All these kinds of devices are going to be connected, and we're already starting to see that trend happen. So that's another great driver for us. And then I would say that the other key driver for us is advanced technology. And we've really been driving the technology roadmap very, very hard. We think it's critical and a key differentiator for Qualcomm relative to our competition, the fact that we're the leaders in HSPA Plus and dual carrier HSPA Plus, and soon to be multi-carrier. We're driving the CD8000 roadmap very hard. We're driving the LTE roadmap very hard. We're leaders in multi-mode LTE chips as well. And the operators are launching these networks increasingly because they have to deal with the demand from the customers. People are continuing to consume more and more data on the devices. I saw a stat yesterday at the the GSMA Leadership Summit that Orange saw, I think it was 26 times growth in the data traffic over the span, I think it was 5 years. So very, very significant growth. The operators see this. They care a lot about the efficiency of the networks that they're running, and we're driving that technology very, very hard. We can afford to invest because we have a leadership position. We're also investing across a broad range of other things. The phone, the chip, and our company is not just about wireless communication. It's also about driving graphics technology, multimedia technology, microprocessor technology, connectivity technology, all of the different pieces that go into making the smartphone that little personal device that all of us carry. And we're really, I think, doing quite well in terms of all of these devices that we're enabling. We launched over 750 different devices with partners last year. So the partnership aspect of our business model continues to work well. I think we've been doing well. You've been seeing the various releases from the manufacturers who have chosen to base their designs on our chipsets. And so we like to say, inside the smartphone, it's the heart of the dragon. So that's our Snapdragon chipset. And we're proud to be part of the success of the partnership. With that, I'll turn it over to Steve Malmkopf, who's going to give you some updates on what's going on the chipset side. Thanks very much for being here.